Some musicians with the Chattanooga Symphony and Opera decided not to play tonight after they received notification from management about a vaccine requirement or a negative test. They were joined by others outside the auditorium in protest tonight. Our Meredith Aldis has the story. Meredith?
Greg, the protest was to raise awareness about the vaccine that could soon be mandated for more employees.
I'm just not willing.
Earlier this week, musicians with the Chattanooga Symphony and Opera received a message from the executive director with updated policies. It says musicians who are fully vaccinated must show proof, or if not fully vaccinated, they must produce a negative COVID test, and masks are required at all times. Victoria Stoddard is 14 years old, and this would have been her third year playing with the symphony. Her mom says when she found out about the mask requirement, it made it a difficult decision to stay or leave.
She has issues with breathing and anxiety and things like that. So I gave her the choice, you know, do you want to play? She loves violin. Do you want to play and deal with this or not? And she said, I can't do it. I can't. My anxiety is too bad.
She says she applied for an exemption and it was denied, so her daughter is no longer with the symphony. Eric Reed and Annie Camp are cellists and were supposed to be playing, but they decided they didn't want to follow the new requirements.
That was dropped on us on a really short notice. We had been hired under the stipulations from last year, which said that we would just wear a mask. We were okay with that. And then they moved the goalpost and tried to ram this through.
To put something which we feel strongly is invasive and unconstitutional, insist that we do that or not work. That's just a double wrong to me.
Labor and employment lawyer Stephen Casada says vaccine mandates are lawful.
The EEOC has said clearly that employers can mandate vaccines of their employees with exceptions under the ADA and Title VII. So those would be disability accommodations and religious accommodations.
He says accommodations like mask wearing, social distancing, or face shields are available if an employee goes through the interactive process under the American Disabilities Act.
So employees always have the right to say no, but what they don't have is the right to continue working for the employer if the employer says, this is my rule.
Soon, we may see more employers follow suit. Earlier this month, the Biden administration announced it's directing OSHA to form an emergency temporary standard that will require all employers with 100 or more employees to get the vaccine or produce a negative test result on a weekly basis. Healthcare employers would be required, or employees would be required to get the vaccine. It could go into effect any day now, and it would last for 6 months. Reporting live in the studio, Meredith Aldis, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.